Okay, hello. Welcome to another Friday Live. This is Christina. Welcome back. Today I'm going to do some stamping and masking and watercoloring, things like that. But I did want to like give you a little update on some stamps that I used. When was it? I think it was back in August with my capsule paper crafting challenge. I used a stamp set from Concord and Ninth that, unbeknownst to me before I picked it, is no longer sold. So it was a little bit frustrating. I recommended some stamp sets that were similar. Anyway, I contacted Greg over at Concord and Ninth, and I said, you know, hey, buddy, like you should make a stamp set similar to that because it was awesome and the techniques were fun. So I'm going to remind you what the card looked like. So I made these two cards. Hold on. I've got envelopes on them. Okay. So do you remember that big, huge block stamp? Remember that? And it had like sketchy lines on it and stuff. Well, Greg heard my plea and they released a stamp set like that in their latest release, which just came out today. This is their entire release, which, let me tell you, is really good. But I have to specifically show you this stamp set. It's lovely. So this piece right here, as you can tell, it's a little bigger than what my original stamp was. So I just thought that was really kind of cool that they went in and did this for us and added some additional shapes. So I can't wait to use the same technique on holiday cards. I think it'd be really fun. Hold on, I gotta turn my phone off. I always have my phone going at the beginning so that I can see if the comments are coming through. And anyway, so isn't that cute? I put it with an orange envelope from Simon. I think this is their orange peel envelope, I think. And then this one that had like the metallic, I just put that with the white envelope. So super cute. Anyway, I thought I'd just give you a little glimpse of their release here at the beginning because it's awesome. And it just came out today and there's a link down below in the video description. I just linked directly to the entire Concord and Ninth release. And then I also linked directly to this stamp set in case you want this specific stamp set. So this one's called Painted Shapes. Anyway, so every year Concord comes out with these really fun, like calendar year cards that you can decorate themselves. So they sent me a couple of these. They've got some great months here. Turnabout stamp set, which gives a really cool pattern. Painted Saying stamp set. Buds and Blossom stamp set. This is so cute. They have some really big stamp sets. They're like the 6x8. I know they've done 6x8 in the past, but they also do the really skinny ones that I think are maybe like 4x8. So I really like these bigger ones. Okay. Oh, goes with that one. Christmas. Love Christmas. Looks like there's a die to go with that. This is all the Merry stamp set. Then they have some awesome alphabets. Look at this. You can do the outline or the fill-in. And then numbers. This one is, what is this? Take a Bow Trimmings Dies. Oh, they have those, I think it's down here. Okay. Take a Bow Concord Die. Concord Night. Take a Bow Encore Dies. Ta-da! So these were really popular a few years ago. So I think they've just made them bigger, maybe updated this out. I'm not entirely sure. I don't think I've used the original ones. They came out right at the beginning. So anyway, so you can use this to put decorations on your tree. And then we have the dies for all the letters and all the numbers. And then of course, my little baby here. Anyway, so big thank you to Greg over at Concord and Ninth for including this new stamp set in their latest release. I'm so excited to use it and I can't wait to do like Christmassy things with it. Okay, let me get these out of the way. Switch to just overhead. And we're going to get into the project for today. Oh, sorry. One more thing. My online class, Simply Watercolor Christmas, starts on Monday. If you haven't had a chance to register, you still can. Most likely you'll have, you know, 75% or even all of the supplies you need for class to participate. So if you want to take my class, it's really fun. It's all Christmas cards. It's all watercolor. I've made it really approachable to all levels of painting, so a lot of people can partake in it. So, okay. All right, let's get going. Get this out of the way. Place it behind me. All right, so this is the stamp set for today's project. I did some prep work because I'm going to be doing a lot of masking. And I remember last week with all the masking, it took like a big bulk of the video. So I decided I better do a little prep, right? So I stamped the images I'm going to be using on masking paper. And I trimmed them out right up next to the lines. And we're going to get going here. Before I do the actual stamping on the project, I'm first going to cut down some scratch paper that it's the exact size of how I want my scene to be. I'm going to do a little scene planning before I get going here. Hold on, guys. I forgot to grab something. And my mic is attached to me, so I have to unattach it for a moment. Okay, sorry, I need to go grab some. Sorry, I need to go grab some paper. I'm gonna put my mic back on me. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna be making a slimline card to go in this envelope, which is a size 10 envelope. But I always find that if I make the card 8.5 by 3.5, it's always just a little bit too small. So I'm gonna make mine a little bigger today. So this envelope is actually 9.5 inches long. So I'm making my card 9 inches long. And then the envelope's just over 4 inches wide or tall. So I'm gonna be making it a little smaller than that. Okay. Yes, you all are addressing the ring. I will address it. I am engaged, affianced, betrothed to be married. I'm not gonna say a whole lot more about that. You got some of you guys who have watched the lives like throughout the weeks might remember a comment back in, I don't know, I think it was August, maybe beginning of September. But I said, I just jokingly under my breath said, oh yeah, 2020 is gonna be so different, right? And anyway, so that's why. So you will see the ring. I got the ring yesterday. It was on order. Ta-da! Back to the project. And thank you for all the congratulations. Okay, so the finished card, I've already cut my watercolor paper, but I thought I'd show you this. I'm making the finished card 9 inches wide by 3 5/8. I'm gonna cut this paper to that size. Alrighty. 9 by 3 5/8. And this is just gonna give me an exact kind of map for where I want my card to go. Okay, back to the stamp. By the way, this stamp set is included in the October 2020 card kit from Simon. Alrighty, I'm grabbing kind of a big block. I don't know, this bear's really big. All right, I'm just making a kind of a map, so I'm not worried about getting like a super precise stamp at this moment. I want this guy kind of right there. I once again forgot to get my stamp chamois wet, so I'm glad I have a clean bucket of water. I'm just gonna dip it. My hand's gonna be super wet. Gross. But that's okay. All right, so now I can clean my stamp. And I'm gonna be using that same ink when I work on my project, so I really don't have to clean my stamp at this point, but I didn't wanna get ink all over my hands, you know? Okay. Then I'm gonna put the little stump right next to him. Alrighty. You guys are funny in the comments. I posted on my personal Facebook page about the engagement yesterday, and I was like, so 2020 wasn't a complete dumpster fire. So that was funny. Anyway, lots of changes coming in the new year. So, okay, put this little guy right on top. He's gonna be standing on the stamp. Helen's asking, is this what the next year comment was about? Yes, you must have just barely arrived. You guys are funny. All right, so, you know what? I just realized I forgot to make a mask for these cute little mushrooms. So I will try to make it so it doesn't touch, because then I don't have to mask. Well, actually, it would have overlapped with the owl anyway. Okay, this is like a hugely massive block. I don't know why I'm using such a big block. Okay, probably because I'm gonna stamp this huge massive tree, right? Okay. That's the next one. Big, huge tree. Okay. Okay. This is a big tree. All right. I'm glad I'm kind of doing this little map here because I'm discovering that I needed to... I think my scene's going to be really off to one side, and I wanted it more center. So when I go to stamp it on my actual project, I can move everything over. Yes, I'm using Versafine right now, but right now it's just the stamp map. So it doesn't necessarily matter what ink I'm using, but eventually I will be using this on the project. Okay, I want my little Christmas tree looking stamp. I'm gonna put this one right next to the other tree, have them overlap. And then pumpkin. Yeah, it is definitely off to one side. Alrighty. Ta-da! That's not that far. It's not that far off, right? Okay, so now I have my little map, and I don't think I'll need all the masks that I made. Okay, so when it comes to masking, you need to think through which images are going to be in the foreground of your design, meaning which images need to be in the very, very front. So, really, all the masking I need to do is over in this area, because over here, well, just kidding, the owl's feet, I'll have to mask that too. Okay, so pencil wise, okay. The owl is going to be in front. I'm just gonna scribble on the ones that need to be in the front. The bear is going to be in the front as well. I'm gonna have this tree be in the background. I'm trying to think here. And I'll have, I think I want the pumpkin in the foreground. So I'm first going to stamp this one. And then I'll stamp this one. So one, two, and then three. Yeah, I think that's a good plan. All right. You know what? And because my project is 9 inches, it's not gonna fit in my regular MISTI. I'm gonna have to grab the big mama. Actually, no. I'm not going to. I will show you how you can do it in the regular MISTI, because you can. All right. So have some Arches cold press watercolor paper. This is the finished card size. I will trim it down a little bit. I think I'll trim off the sides. So it's 9 by 3 5/8. See how it just barely doesn't touch over there? I'm just, you know, I'm just gonna make sure it's in this corner while I'm stamping. And then if I need to double stamp something, I know it's in the right place. All right, and for my little mask here, because I wanna get it all centered up and look right, I'm gonna do this. All right, and I'm also going to cut off the bottom. Okay, so I want to get this centered on my watercolor paper. Let's slide that over. All right, and I am going to, let's see, how do I want to do this to make sure that it's going to be correct at all times, like I can keep moving it. I'm trying to think the best way to do this. Okay, I think what the easiest thing to do would be is I'm gonna go like this and tape it right up here. And I'm also going to, with my pencil, just make a little tiny line on either side so that I can erase those later. And then I can lift this up while I'm stamping, right? Okay. Because of that, I'm going to turn it so that it can come outside my MISTI. Okay. But then I can always like line it back up to where those pencil lines are. Okay. Where'd my magnet go? Oh, it's right here. Hello. Put the magnet right there. Okay. Alrighty. Now let's get to the stamping. So the bear needs to be in the most front. It's in front of all the trees, in front of everything. So I'm going to stamp the bear first and then apply a mask. So I'm going to put my little bear right over the top. Grab my stamp. Then I'm going to open this up. First, I'm going to get that right there and then I can open it. Sorry, my door of my MISTI is off the camera, but you guys get the idea. And I come up here and stamp him. Okay. And I'm going to stamp him twice to get a really good impression. And my paper didn't move, thankfully. So I can just come right back in and stamp again. Okay. Ta-da! Cleaning off my stamp. And put that back on the sheet. And now I'm going to grab my mask. I've got these masks I've already created. Specifically, so I don't have to spend the time now to do it. I'm going to zoom in a little. There we go. So I'm going to put my little bear mask right over the top. Ta-da! Okay. So now I'm going to bring this down. I'm going to line up the pencil edges on either side. And now I can stamp. Let's just go ahead and do the tree, except we want, let's see, we want the pumpkin to be in the very front and these trees to be behind the pumpkin. So we're going to stamp the pumpkin first. So here's our cute pumpkin. And we'll flip this up, keeping my paper in place. Then I'm going to ink up my stamp. All right, so now I have my cute pumpkin. That was a pretty good stamp. I don't think I even need to do it twice. So I'm going to go ahead and remove my stamp from my MISTI door and move on. All right, we need a mask on the little pumpkin. If I can peel it off. I saw someone in the comments last week. They're like, you know what? I use an X-Acto knife to go between the backing sheet and the mask. That to me just sounds like an injury waiting to happen. But I'm also the one who like loves to cut with an X-Acto knife. So I guess it's just whatever you're comfortable with, right? Okay, so our pumpkin's in place. So now we're gonna line this back up with the pencil marks. And we're gonna move on to, we want this tree to be in the farthest back. So we're gonna go to this next one. You always start with which images are closest to you and then move back. So I'm gonna go to the triangle shaped tree. Okay, I'll put this right there. And continue stamping. Thank you for all the sweet congratulations and comments in the chat. Originally, I wanted to just, I thought it would be really funny to like just have it, I'm suddenly wearing a ring in a video, like a regular edited video, and then just not say anything, just see what you guys said. But then the ring came yesterday and, you know, here we are. So, I've actually been engaged for over a month, but didn't have the official ring, so I was waiting. All right. Now let's go for the little tree mask. Hello? There we go. Okay. Bring this little thing back down and move to the big tree. Make sure my little map is lined up. And then, ooh, that tree is really close to the top. I'm gonna bring it down just a little bit. So it won't be quite the same placement as the map, but that's okay. Make sure that's in the corner. Pick up the tree. Here we are. I just saw Melina's question about making DIY wedding invitations. I'm sorry, you will not ever see that from me, mostly because I'm a graphic designer. So for years, I've always recommended, like, if you're going to invite a lot of people to your wedding, unless you really are adamant and want to spend the time, I would not recommend doing handmade invitations just because they'll take a really long time to create. I would just find a design you really love and have it printed. That's kind of my thing. Like, save your handmade cards for thank you cards. Okay, that tree's a little crooked now that I'm looking at it. Whatever, I'll get over it. Yeah, and COVID times are weird, so obviously we won't be having a lot of people at our wedding. So that's how it goes. Alrighty, so the last few things to stamp don't even need masks, so this should go pretty quick. All right, I'm lining up my little map again. Actually, we do have a mask. We need to do the L first. I keep forgetting about the dang L. All right, and it's really close on the little card plan to the bear, and I want to make sure that it's not going to overlap the bear. So before I ink up my stamp, I'm just going to test it. Oh yeah, it should be okay. All right. Lots of questions about the wedding. I'm actually not going to say too much about our plans online, just because, you know, the internet. But I'll just say early 2021. Stamping this little guy twice to get a really good impression. Alrighty. Now we need the mask for him, which is right here. I don't know. It looks like a boy owl. Of course, it could be a girl, but he looks like a boy to me. Okay. Bringing the map back down, getting it lined up. And now I'm going to stamp the little stump. Okay. In fact, you know what? At this point, I'm getting closer to this edge here. I'm going to slide my card over to this other corner so that it's flat on this side. That's going to give me a better stamp impression. Okay. Make sure I'm in that corner. Stamp the little stump. I'm going to stamp that twice. There's just a little line in there that didn't get all the way. All right. And then we're going to do these other two. I don't think I can stamp them at the same time, even though they're not touching. I think they're just a little too close. I think the edge of the stamp. Well, I don't know. I guess I could try. All right. Make sure I get my... Oh, I need to put this back on. Make sure I have my little map in the right spot. Get my little mushroom. Yeah, it's going to be too close. I'll stamp them separate. Pretty good impression. I don't think I need to stamp twice. And then the little old mushroom. And I probably could just stamp this wherever I want, but I'll use the map. It's just giving me some good planning. Okay. Now this little guy. Ta-da. He's going to get stamped twice. Okay. And then I have one more little stamp I want to add that's not on my map. But I want to put this little... Actually, you know what? Maybe I'll pop it up on a separate piece of paper. I don't know. I want him saying hi there. So I may have to do that separate. Hold on 1 minute. I have piano movers at my house. I've got to close my door. Hold on. Okay. All right. Sorry about that. Yeah, my mom's meeting the piano movers. And so anyway, okay. So I was going to put that little greeting, but I stamped him too close to the top of the card. Bummer. I forgot about that. I was going to have that little there, but that's okay. I am going to remove the masks, and I like to put my masks after I've made them. You know, if they're still usable, if I can use them multiple times, I'll take the stamp set and I'll just put it right over the image on the back, and then I have it masked for next time. So grab my little bear, put the mask over him. I can grab this tree and the pumpkin. All right. So on my plan, I thought it'd be really cute to put these cute little like hipster glasses on the bear, because it's just cute. So get those straight. Da-da-da. Okay, I'm glad I have this in my MISTI, because that really did not stamp well because it's a thick line. So we will stamp again. Much better. All right. I will go with that. And then maybe I'll put a greeting over here or something, since I can't put one above the bear. It's just a little too tight up there. Or I guess I could draw my own little bubble and put it up there. Yeah, we don't know. Okay. I'm gonna put my MISTI away. Peel off my little map. See, now we're a half hour in. Aren't you glad I already made my masks? Because that would have made this video even longer. Of course, I did spend a lot of time talking about the Concord release, but anyway. All right. Let's get to some watercoloring. Oh, hold on. I still have this mask I didn't use, and I don't want to lose it. So I'm going to go ahead and peel it off and put it on the back of the stamp set anyway, even though I didn't use it. I wasn't sure what I would need today, so I just made masks for the main images. Okay. All right. Okay. So I think I will... Oh, crap. I just dropped my remote. Hold on. Okay. I think I will tape this to a board today. I don't... You know, I'll tape it to a board, and then when I get to painting the background, I'll take the tape off so I can paint to the edge. I wasn't thinking. I should have made my watercolor paper even larger, but I wanted to have the size relation to the actual finish card, like while I was planning it. So that was my bad. Okay. Alrighty. Andrea. Andrea in the comments. I'm pretty sure that is an affliction of many people. A lot of people forget. Right? I do all the time. And then I have to like restamp it, make it bigger, you know, all that stuff. Hold on. I'm putting a few things away. Getting ready to paint. All right, the paints I'm using today are my Mijello Mission Gold. And open this up. These are my paints. Got pencils everywhere. Okay. All right. Erasing my little pencil lines I use to guide myself with the map. All right. Okay, let's pick some paintbrushes. I've got to pull a bunch out so I can actually see them and drop them. Okay, You know what? I think that one might work. But I think one dropped on my work surface. Oh no, those are okay. All the little ones didn't make it over. Okay. We'll do little one, big one. Yeah, that seems about right. Are those the same? They are. Okay. I have two of the same brush. I'm like, wait a minute. Okay. Kristen Nova asked which stamp set I used. This is the Happy Fall Y'all stamp set from Simus's Stamp. It's linked down in the video description. And it's in their October 2020 card kit. So, hello. Yeah, it's linked down below. You can click through. There's also a stamp set from Concord and Ninth that I linked today called Painted Shapes. That one's really good too. Okay. So I think I want to, well, first I'm going to zoom in for you. All right. Paper towel is all the way across here. Here we go. Hello. I forgot to say hello to all of you from all over the world today. I usually do. So hello. Hello, everyone. All right. You know, I'm really feeling these trees, so I'm going to start painting the trees. And I just have a bunch of like green colors. I'm not going to be real picky. I'm just going to like start painting some green, and then I can bring in some blue maybe. I just want to like mix some greens to get, you know, like a really cool watercolor look. Could be very, very freehand. I can come in and add additional things later, like some shading if I want. But I really just want like a mixture of greens right now. Get a little more water on my brush. Just come in and paint the little tree shape. I'm gonna grab that original green that I used, kind of like that olivey green. Bring that in down here at the bottom. That paint's pretty thick. Kind of makes me think of like the trees in the fall. They get all sorts of like variations in color. They turn like different shades of green and then going into yellow and orange. Oh yeah, there's still some kind of green trees in the fall. It's all good. Okay. This tree looks very full. I don't think it's got dead stuff on it yet. But I could also bring in some browns. In fact, I might. Having a brown kind of in the mix here, I think would be really pretty actually. All right. Okay, I'm gonna paint the pumpkin. I'll skip this one since that edge is still drying. I'll go into the pumpkin. So I'm gonna start with like a yellowy orange kind of near the top. And then I'm going to go to a more traditional orange near the bottom. And this paint is really thick today, so I'm adding some water. I'm losing all my yellow, but that's okay. We'll come back later. In fact, I'm gonna go like that. pick up some of that color. Perfect. All right. Let's go ahead and do the mushrooms over here. I've got a nice brown shade that I can use, so I'm just going to grab some brown over here. And I'm going to do the same brown on this little guy. All right. I really want the sweater on the bear to be kind of like mostly maroon. So let's see, he's going to be maroon. So maybe I'll make his scarf like orange. So it kind of picks up the orange that's over here. So I'm just going to get an orange shade going on my palette. And I think it's going to be orange and brown. So I don't want it to be alternating. So get a little water on my brush. And I can just come spread this out. The paint is really concentrated today. I can add some shading later. Oh yeah, orange and brown on like a brown owl will be really pretty. All right, I'm gonna grab some additional brown. Let's see, what color brown do I want? I will do this shade right here. And I'm just going to do some brown on the tree stump. All right, and I'll come back and add a little shading on that in a bit. I'm kind of like skipping around to different areas. I'm going to go ahead and just dry this so I can go back to the tree. Okay, I'm going to use that same brown that I used on the stump for the tree trunk. Just a really simple brown. This is a really messy watercoloring today. I'm not being super precise. For Zazzy. He better like cats. He does. He loves the girls. Okay. And while I'm at it, I'll go ahead and just paint this trunk as well. There are so many pieces to this picture. I wasn't even thinking. I'm using Arches Cold Press watercolor paper today. Someone just asked that. All right, get a little pink on his cheeks for a blush. And you know, I know bare feet are generally like the pads of the feet are black. Well, maybe I will make them black. I was gonna make him pink like a cat, but I'll make it more accurate. Okay, I'm gonna mix up a more brownish orange to go like put some shading on my pumpkin. And I'm also going to switch to a smaller brush because I think a smaller brush will just give me a little bit more control for adding details. So I'm just going to add a little bit down at the bottom. Get my brush wet. And then I can like soften out that line. got my brush wet again, and I can soften the top edge even further. Okay, so now we're getting a little more shading. That was the difference. I think I needed to add or to use a smaller brush. Okay, I'm gonna grab green and just come in here for the trunk, not the trunk, the stem. I can't think today. And I'm going to grab a brown for the owl's scarf. You know, if I would have been thinking, I should have given the owl like a Harry Potter scarf. Like make it gold and maroon or something. I think that'd be hilarious. Because, you know, owls are really big in Harry Potter. Just using a clean brush that has water on it to kind of push the brown more. And while I have this brown going, I'm just going to add a little bit of shadow right at the bottom going across. Alrighty. All right, let's think about this tree right here. Maybe I'll make that, I'm trying to think what color. Maybe I'll have it be like a golden yellow so that it really is more like a fall tree. All right, I'm trying to find, these yellows are all pretty bright in this palette. I'm like, how do I calm it down? I think I'll add a little brown to it to calm it down so it's a little more like a tan. Okay. Yeah, here we go. Here's a golden yellow shade. And then while it's wet, maybe I'll just add some red colors. Or the, I kind of have like a reddish brown shade. Maybe I'll just add that. I can just drop it in just like in a few little spots. So it's kind of like a fall color. There we go. I'm not sure if I'm convinced that I like that, but I'll go with it. Alrighty. All right, I'm gonna work on the bear's sweater, which, like I said, I wanted it to be like a maroon. It's really bugging me that the tree, these trees are supposed to be behind the bear, but the bear is up higher than the tree. You know, seriously, there was a problem with me stamping this. Whatever, we'll just go with it. So, anyway, okay, so I'm gonna mix a nice maroon shade. All right, we're gonna see some paint mixing for a moment. I'm gonna zoom out so you can see, because I was like, oh, I don't have a color that's like the one I want. How am I gonna get that color? So I'm gonna start with this kind of red shade up here. Get a little more water. Just gonna like get that on my palette. Nice big puddle, because I don't know how much red I'm gonna need. And then green is its complementary color. So I'm gonna add, grab just this green down here and add the smallest amount, and it starts to tone back the red. You can also add a little bit of brown. I think that would work well too. In fact, I might do that. I'm just gonna add a little bit of this brown up here. In fact, it doesn't have to be like a super brown maroon color right now, because I can always do a lighter shade initially, and then I'll get more when I add shading. Okay, I think that color looks pretty nice. In fact, I've got watercolor paper here. Let's test that. Oh yeah, that's a nice rusty shade. Okay, switching back to my smaller brush, and I'm also going to zoom in so we can see what's happening more again. Okay. And I'm just going to start painting his sweater. This nice maroon shade. I think I'll come in and add, I'll make the alternating stripes like a darker shade. I'll just paint along. Hello, everyone who's just joining. Add a little more color right down here at the bottom. So that's where naturally there'd be a little more shading. Okay. And now I'm going to do the sleeves. I also need to do the neck of the sweater, but we'll get to that. Alrighty. This bear looks very distinguished. He looks like he should be a professor at a college. I'm now going to call him Professor Bear. Okay. Because I just want to get that sweater done with, I'm going to dry it. All right. And then coming back to my little, you know how I made this like little puddle of color? I'm going to add more of that dark brown to it until it gets even darker. Or I could just use the dark brown actually. I'm going to use that to add a little bit of color difference on the stripes. So you know, it might not be enough of a color difference now that I'm looking at it. So I might have to just use the straight brown. I don't know. It might be okay. We'll keep it. Alrighty. But I am going to use it, the dark shade, on the cuffs of the sweater. On the neckline and the bottom band. There we go. This side got really dark. Not sure how that happened, but that's okay. Alrighty. People keep asking about putting the sides of the glasses on the bear. I'm not going to because I think it would look a little weird. I'm not gonna worry about it. Alrighty. So I'm gonna grab a little bit of a grayish black because there needs a little shadow here. I'm just gonna go ahead and paint in a little bit of a shadow. I might totally be ruining this, but that's okay. We'll just go with it. I'll come in and soften it in a minute here. I just feel like there wasn't enough difference to show the actual shading. There, I feel a little better about that. Another comment about drawing lines from the glasses to the bear's ears. Once again, not going to do that. But while I do have this black shade out, I'm going to go ahead and paint his nose. I'm going to leave a little gap for a glare. And I'm going to paint his toes as well while I've got the black out. Cleaned off my brush. I'm going to use that to just spread the paint out a little. Okay, I'm going to let that dry and move on to the owl. I'm going to refer to my swatch chart for which brown to use on the owl. I think, okay, this is the brown I'm going to use. It's a nice golden brown. Getting lots of brown shades on this painting, right? Let's see. I think I need just a little more water with this color. It's just a little too dry. I'm like picking up straight from the palette and not squiggling the paint onto the actual palette. I'm just picking it straight up from the well, and it makes the paint very thick. All right, we'll put this color on the eye area as well. All right, I have no idea if an owl has an orange beak, but I'm gonna use kind of like this rusty color on his beak. Yeah, the brown's more of a goldeny brown color, almost a little green. So yeah, I'm gonna bring in, he's gonna be a little bit like a tan owl. So I'm really watering down like a tan shade for, let's see, is that the color I want? No, that's a little too yellow. Trying to find a good brown to complement the owl's coloring already. So I'm mixing a bunch of colors, trying to get the color I want. See, I'm like testing them all out. I'm like, okay, which is gonna look better? I'm not in love with any of them yet. Oh well, I'm just gonna go with this one. I think it's just gonna have to work. And it might work, I don't know. Getting my paintbrush wet so I can just spread this across and down below. And then I'm going to get, I don't know if owls have orange feet, dark feet. I don't know. These are going to be just like a, oh crap, I forgot. Okay, we'll use that. We'll have that be the shading on the bottom of the owl. I forgot I just painted that area. Right there. Alrighty. I'm going to take the same dark maroon shade and paint this mushroom. I always think of mushrooms as red with big white dots on them. Probably because of Super Mario Brothers. Okay. And I want that, don't want that quite that dark, so I'm just gonna hit that with my paper towel. There we go. And then the top of this mushroom, maybe I will just have it be brown. Okay. All right, now I want a really nice brown for the bear. So here are my browns. I think this one's probably gonna be the best bet. It's kind of more of a neutral brown, so it won't be too warm or compete with the dark red on the bear. So, and it's, I think it might even be the same brown that I used right here. Could be wrong. Okay, so we'll just start down here on the bottom of his tummy and we'll see if this really is the brown we want. I have a feeling it's going to be though. Because he's kind of like a brown grizzly bear. Pick up some of that color. Yeah, there we go. I like that. All right, so now I know I need to just water it down some because it's just a little too dark as is straight from the palette. Okay. Get his little hand up here. I'll get his hand right here too. I think I'm gonna have to come back and darken up his toes because it's looking really gray next to this brown and not black, like his nose up there. I think I didn't get it quite dark enough before. Okay. Alrighty. I want his snout to be a little bit lighter than the rest, so I'm going to skip painting that for now. Trying to spread this color out really far. It's not really working. Okay. Alrighty. I'm going to dry this so we can continue on with the bear. I'm going to grab a slightly darker brown just to add just a little bit of shading right there. I'm gonna soften that out. In fact, I may have added too much paint. Get some more water on there. Before I spread that out, I'm just getting a clean brush and trying to walk it back just a little bit. Get a little bit of that shading over there. Coming back with a clean damp brush and just spreading that out some more. I'm gonna do the same for the ear area. Just to get a little shading in there. There, he looks pretty cute. All right, now I'm gonna go back to the black and blacken up his feet. Oh yeah, much better. And I'm being a little messy, but anyway. All right, for his little snout area, I just want like a much lighter version of the rest of him. So I'm just adding a lot of water to my paint on my palette. Let's test that, make sure it's pretty pale, even paler. Okay, I think this will work. And then I can come in and do this. Just add a little more. I'm gonna have to get his nose with the black too. Cause now the nose doesn't look black compared to the feet. Alrighty. Back to the black. There we go. Alright, I'm grabbing the brown for the top of the stump. And it can be pretty dark since the owl is right on top. And I'm also going to do just a little bit of shading the darkest areas. Just soften that out. Okay. Come back to the brown on the mushrooms. And I'm just going to add a little bit of shading. Okay. I'm going to grab that dark brown and just add a little bit of variation on these tree trunks. I need to slow down. I'm getting really messy here. Okay. All right. We're looking pretty good. Okay. All right. Try and decide what I want to do here. I think I want to add a little more shading on this right here. Kind of tone back the orange shade a little bit. And that brown is really the same color of brown that's on the owl, so maybe I'll just bring in black. You know, and it'll kind of look like a little bit of a Halloween scarf. Maybe. I think that could work. Oh, and I forgot that it was wet. That's okay. It'll just look like shading. Okay. That's better. All right. I think I'm feeling pretty good about where I'm at, other than I want a little more color on the bear's face right here. There we go. All right. So now I'm going to remove the tape because we're going to be painting the ground. I think I'll just remove just that much. I could have the bear be sitting on a rock. I could have him, I don't even know. I don't know. Actually, you know what? Let's figure this out. I'm grabbing a waterproof black pen. And I really think the tree should be about right there, right? So, and this other one can be a little more in the foreground. How am I gonna do this? I'm gonna fix it. I am determined to fix it. sitting on leaves, tree trunk, same as owl. I probably could. I could put the mask back on and stamp the tree. That might be the best option, other than I've just put a line on my tree, but that's okay. Because I was thinking I might be able to just like make like a mound of some sort. I don't want to do this. Okay. All right. Really wish he wasn't like that. You know what? Okay, if this wasn't a live video and I really was just fixing this, I would totally cut him out, cut the owl out, and then repaint these images too and cut them out separately and then adhere them onto a card front with foam tape. I don't know that I want to repaint all of these, so I'm not gonna do that today. I'm gonna try to salvage this in some creative way. How am I gonna do this? Okay. All right, here we go. All right, you know what? Christina, learn from your mistakes. Use a pencil first. Okay. I'm just trying to figure out exactly what to do here. Okay. Okay, I have an idea. Okay, I have to go grab, actually, can I use this? No, I could use the back maybe. I'm gonna cut out a separate piece of watercolor paper and have it be like a ground of some sort, and it will cover the foreground area. Actually, no, I don't like that idea. Someone just came in. What are we making today? Well, we're making mistakes. I'm trying to fix things. Okay. All right. This might be making a mistake even worse, but I will feel better about it. Apparently they're all sitting on black asphalt. I didn't even know what to call this. You know, whoever I give this card to, I'm just going to tell them, don't think too hard about it. Just go with it. Okay. And then I need to get a smaller brush if I'm going to do that. Where is my small brush? It's hiding. Come back. Okay. All right, I think this is salvaging it. This isn't the exact look I was going for originally, but I'm making it work. I like what someone said. It's just dark nutrients for the ground. Right? Oh no, I got rid of my paper towel. I need a new one. All right, because I don't think I want quite that dark right at the bottom. You guys are gonna start thinking that I plan to mess up during these lives. Honestly, you guys, I do not. I try to be as prepared as possible. It's a struggle. All right, well, I think that helps save it. You can still see this right here. So I'm just gonna come back over with some really strong black once again and just fill in this little area. Hopefully it'll hide the tree. I do feel better about that. I feel so much better about it. And I think as far as the sky goes, I'm gonna keep more of the horizon plain white, but I do want to add just a little bit of color to the sky. Trying to think, I might have to Google like autumn sky or something just to see like what would be the best color. So let's do that. I'm gonna Google autumn sky. Here we go. Images. I just see like I'm looking at like these really dramatic images. Okay, let's just see which is, well, lots of blue, like straight on blue. I'm not feeling the blue on this. I think blue would be a little too. Let's see here. Maybe something like this where it's got like dark brown at the edges and comes into like an orangey red and then fades to a yellow. Let's do it. All right. So I'm going to get some orange colors mixed up that I can use on my sky. Some like orangey reds. Okay. All right, this might be furthering mistakes, but I'm going to go with it. Actually, I'm not. I'm not ready to go with it yet. Okay, cleaning off my brush. I'm going to get like a golden yellow. All right. Oh, crap. There we go. In fact, this might be all it really needs is just like a golden yellow coming, kind of coming down. Almost looks a little ominous, but I think I wanted to get a little bit of color on here first before I start putting on some really dramatic sky, because that could be bad. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to come in with a little bit of orange just up here at the top. This is looking very dramatic. Okay. I like where this is kind of going. I like it. It's like kind of like they're glowing. But I do think it needs, I just need to bring this a little farther down. And I also need to make sure I bring this all the way down to the images. Okay. I'm liking that so much more. You know what is really standing out and not looking right? The bright green. So before, I don't know, do I dare? I was going to add like a brownish green right over the top, just like a glaze, just to like tone it back. Cause it's kind of intense there. That bright green. I mean, I do like green leaves mixed in with like other fall shades, but I don't know about those. Okay, first, let's dry this. Okay. All right. The opposite of green is red. And so that would dull down the bright green. But there's something I want to try before I do that. I don't know if it's going to work, so we're just going to try it on a little portion. If I get this wet, that did pull off a little, pull up a little color. So right up here, if I do the same, that's not pulling up that much, but it is a little bit, right? All right. Okay. Like a reddish brown, I think, as a glaze would kind of just tone that back. It's too much. Add more water. That's not reddish, that's more yellow. We're gonna add a little of this in. Okay, whatever. We're going for it. This might be a mistake, switching to a smaller brush, because I don't want to flood this area. Okay. You know what? I don't know that it's really going to do anything that I want it to do. Might not be able to see much of a difference until it's dry. Because right now it just looks like it's intensifying the green. I'm like, no! Okay. Let's dry this. Okay, I think it did just tone it back just a little bit. I don't know that I want to keep messing with it. I think if I keep messing with it, it will make it worse. I don't like that edge right there. Hold on. Hoping this will. Come on, honey. Soften that out. All right. I think I'm ready to be done with this problematic painting. Gonna put my paint set to the side and can zoom out a little. All right, so I did prepare, let me see if I still have it, my card base. Do I want to trim this down a little bit? I think I might, because I find that using foam tape really makes warped watercolor paper kind of sit down more. So, you know what? You can still see the outline of the tree trunk. Whatever. It's fine. I'm all good over it. So, all right. You know what? I have an idea on how this is going to finish off. Okay. Got my card base here. This is cut to 9 by 7 1/4, and I'm going to score it at 3 5/8. So I'm going to have to do 3 5/8 from each end because my scoreboard's not long enough. So 3 5/8. And then, 3 5/8. Lovely. so this will be the exact size of the card front, right? But it is pretty warped. I'm still going to put it on foam tape because I think it needs the foam tape to hold it down. And foam tape just seems to be a little more forgiving because the foam is flexible. So I'm just going to add it on. Someone's like, you're a perfectionist. It looks great. Yes, I am a perfectionist, but also I'm just, you know, trying to go with the flow. Like I mentioned earlier, if I was not on the hair live, I probably would have just cut out the bear and then cut out the owl and the log and like repurpose them, use them on something else. Alrighty. Okay, so the foam gives it some stability. See how much more straight it is? It's just gonna give it, make it a whole lot more flat on the card. So even though it's the exact same size as the card front, I'm still going to adhere it using foam tape to give it more stability. And it'll be even more flat once I have it down on the card. Alrighty. Actually, my card is not completely straight on both sides, but that's okay. All right. So that holds it down really well. And then my idea to finish off the card is, let's see, make sure I've got the right pen here. Okay, do we want to do it this way? I think I do. Okay. Okay, here we go. And then, ta-da! I don't know. I just felt like it like continued on or whatever. But I also considered adding just like a black border around the outer edge, which I guess I still could, but I kind of think I like it like that. All right. So that is the card for today. This was a journey. You know what? I really have been trying to keep these to an hour, but they always end up being an hour and a half. So here we are. Here we are. Oh, you can't even see the... Oh, hold on. Let me zoom out so you can actually see most of the card. I'm like, this is ridiculous. Okay. All right. Okay, so that is the card for today. Thank you all for joining me. Do you have any questions before I head out? I kind of like how this hello like fills in that gap over in that corner. Almost looks like weird electrical wire going through the forest. All right. Well, I'm gonna call it a day. Call this finished, wrapped up. Thank you again for all your congratulations. For those who missed it, yes, I'm engaged. I'm affianced. I am betrothed to be married. Wedding will happen in early 2021, COVID style. You might hear about it, might not. I'm trying to keep it a little private, but anyway, thank you all for joining me today. You can get this stamp set. It's called Happy Fall, y'all, over at simonsthestamp.com. A link to the stamp set, as well as everything I've used today, will be included in the supplies. If you're watching this live, not everything is listed now, but as soon as I'm done and I've closed out the live stream, I'll go to my computer and make the supply list, and I'll update the video description down below. So thank you again for joining me. This was a lot of fun. This was, as I said, a journey. We got there. lots of lots of learning moments, and I hope you guys caught them. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next week. Oh, before I go, next week, the live is not at noon. It will be at 4 o'clock. I have something in the midday, so I can't do the live right at noon. So it will be at 4 Mountain Time, 6 Eastern. So it'll be 4 hours later than usual. So if any of you are watching this on the replay and you usually watch it a few hours later, maybe next week you can catch it live. So thanks again for joining me, and I will see you guys next week.